south side of Chicago. Welcome to the home of the White Sox Guaranteed Rate Field. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the St. Louis Cardinals and the San Diego Padres. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Now at the plate is Tommy Edman. He will lead this one off today. The 1-1. 65 degrees our temperature here at first pitch. The set and the 2-1 pitch. Heading out towards shallow right. Tatis is there for route number one. Digging in next, Paul Goldschmidt.
The first baseman.
Paul. One out, nobody on. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out. Up next, Tyler O'Neill. Head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. He's 0 for 5. Popped him up. Frazier is under it. And he makes the catch to retire the side. And now, Fernando Tatis Jr. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Wainwright ready, the 1-1.
That's a ball.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
3-2.
Okay. Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Drill to the right side. At the plate, Manny Machado. Sharp ground ball to third. And just past his outstretched glove into left. Hit.
That is good. That's shortstop.
Stepping in now, Jake Cronenworth. And he fouls this one off. Tatis over at second. Machado on at first with nobody out. Hit back up the middle. He's got it. The second for one. Relay to Goldie, and that gets him as well a double play. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Will Myers. Runner in scoring position with two gone.
Will Myers.
Payoff pitch on its way.
Hey, what a job right here to put yourself in position to get out of this one after giving up back-to-back singles to the first two batters.
Pulled high in the air out to left field. O'Neill waits on it, and that ends the inning. Second inning set to go, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Nolan Arenado. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. Swung on and missed. He didn't even come close to contact on a ball way out of the zone. One out. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. Head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. He's 0 for 7. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Stepping up is Dylan Carlson, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. The 1-1.
Man, you don't see this in today's game that much. A guy who's willing to work east-west consistently with a great cutter two-seamer combo.
Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And the throw to first ends the inning. Striding in is Eric Hosmer, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Molina, shading to his right, makes the play, one away. Next to hit, Victor Caratini.
The catcher, Victor Caratini.
Curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. And it's fouled away. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. O'Neill waits on it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that brings up Trent Grisham. Bottom of the second here with no score. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Fly ball right down the line and left. On the run is O'Neill. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. So here is Edmundo Sosa, 7-8-9, bottom of the order, set to go here in the third. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. A ball and two strikes. And he looks at a cold strike three as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one. And that'll bring up the former top prospect, Harrison Bader. Head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. He's 0 for 5. Bouncer up the middle. And that's the first hit in this one for the Redbirds. Into the box now, Adam Wainwright, Cardinals pitcher up there with a 1-2 count. And this is taken for a ball high and tight, 2-2.
You certainly know he's not trying to pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
3-2, full count. Swing and a miss, and another punch out here. 6 already, and that's out number 2. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Tommy Edman, 0 for 1 here in the early going. In for strike 2. Bader is off of first with 2 away. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
3-2.
Full count now. 3-2. Into the corner and slicing foul. Darvish a check on first. And he'll be back in standing up. And here's a cut fastball that misses down and away for ball 4. And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. 2 on, 2 out for him here in the third. He's set. The 3-2. And he struck him out. His 7th of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Third now, and that brings up Adam Frazier. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Nope, that's inside.
you can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
On the ground to the right side. And that's the first down. So one out and nobody aboard. And the pitcher bats next. That'll be Yu Darvish. Wainwright looks in. Here's the 1-1. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Fernando Tatis Jr., who collected a base hit his first time up. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
I got 2-1 to count.
Popped him out. Goldschmidt in foul ground. And that ends the inning. So now here is Tyler O'Neill. Flew out last time up.
Almost, Maddie. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Count even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him. One man gone for the Cardinals in the fourth. And in next, it'll be the perennial MVP candidate, third baseman Nolan Arenado. Strike swinging, timing a little off on that one. Swing and a liner. And that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances. To the plate now, Yadier Molina. All even now, 2-2. Fouled away. Both teams with just 2 hits apiece thus far. And this will ricochet off of him on the mound. To second for one. On to Hosmer. A double play, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that'll bring in Manny Machado.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Here's a fly ball. Well hit. O'Neill looks up. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. Into the box, Jake Cronenworth. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball 4. Next up, Will Myers comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 2-1, here it is. In there, now the throw. Not in time, he's in there at second. Still even at 2-2. One run on 3 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Now at the plate, Eric Hosmer 0-for-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop up foul.
Now a ball lined hard toward deep right field. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? Next to bat will be Victor Caratini. Flew out in his only at bat so far. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. And he popped him up. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four. Next, here is Trent Grisham. He's 0-1 thus far. That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and they get right back outside. Nice pitch.
Grounded back up the middle. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Digging in, the switch hitter, Dylan Carlson. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
So it was a strikeout swinging. Goes down for the first out in the fifth inning. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Fouled off. Another 2-2 offering. Now a ball lined hard toward right center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. So next to hit is Harrison Bader. He singled in his first AB. No runs, two hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here. Next to hit will be the pitcher. Adam Wainwright struck out in his last trip to the plate. Even count, two balls and two strikes. Here now the 2-2. And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. Tommy Edman. A little low. It's 2-2.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
Protecting with two strikes. Went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. And he fouls this one off. Strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Adam Frazier. The 3-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Reined in. Throws in time, and that's out number one. So here now is the pitcher, Yu Darvish, grounded out in his last at-bat. Look into Molina, now the 1-1. This is popped up. Arenado will look this one in, and that's out number two. Back to the top of the order now, and up steps the big bat of Fernando Tatis Jr.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. O'Neill looks up. Gone! Now to the plate, Manny Machado. A ball and two strikes now.
Hey, I don't blame him for giving up on that curveball. That was a rainbow coming out of the sky. Stole a strike.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at two. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Another payoff pitch. In the air, out to right. No trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll bring up the big bat of Paul Goldschmidt. Line drive to left, and that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far. So the inning's underway with the Cardinals getting their leadoff hitter on base. At the plate, Tyler O'Neill. And he takes a big swing at that one as this one's lifted high in the air and deep out to left field. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run. Ladies, Ross Detweiler takes over on the mound here with nobody out in the sixth inning. Standing in now, Nolan Arenado. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone. Lifetime versus this arm. He's 2-for-4. He's taken him deep once. Changeup swung on and missed for the first out. Next to dig in, Yadier Molina 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. Now a swing and a ball foul tip straight into the catcher's glove as he's able to hold on for the second out. Next to hit is Dylan Carlson, 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Now it'll be Jake Cronenworth, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Stepping in now, Will Myers. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Curveball got him swinging for the first out. First baseman Eric Hosmer is in. He's popped out and lined out. 0-for-2 thus far.
Hosmer.
Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
And it's fouled away. Here he comes again. 1-2. And through 5 1/3, already coming up on 100 pitches here.
Yeah, Matty V, this pitch count continues to go up.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Looking up is the right fielder, and this one is gone, a home run. Genesis Cabrera, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill. Into the box, Victor Caratini. Swing, and this is also hit well out to deep center. Bader is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. And the hit will be Trent Grisham, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. 3-1. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of a steal when he's on base.
The second baseman, Adam Frazier.
And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Now a throw over to first, and he just manages to get his hand in. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. High in the air down the right field line. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. Into the box, Edmundo Sosa hit the ball pretty well in his last at bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
One ball. And that fastball's too much for him there. One and two. Look out. That one almost got away from him. Two and two now.
That's a good pitch right there. But, you know, as a base stealer, when you're in the box like that, you want to protect your money makers, right? You don't want anything around your knees or your feet. So he was fortunate to get out of the way of that one.
So he sets him down swinging. Edmundo Sosa was down for the first out in the seventh inning. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
No, that's a ball.
Fouled away.
Wow, that's four straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number five right here. You could tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
Ready with another 2-2. Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. Five straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are two away. Bases are empty here with two men out. One and two now.
He's one pitch away from striking out the side, but even more than that, to throw a donut up after your offense put up some runs, I can't tell you what that means to the boys in the dugout.
And that's going to be high. Two and two now. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. Three and two.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Cronenworth
ranging into the outfield. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Cody Whitley will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh. Jurickson Profar is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down one and two now. Pulled toward right center field. Edmund trying to get there, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. Next, it'll be Fernando Tatis Jr. Blasted a solo homer last time up. And this is taken for a called strike.
One ball.
Oh, that's a tough call. Now one and two. Hit on the ground out to short. And that's the second out. Two outs now in the San Diego seventh. And standing in now, the always dangerous third baseman, Manny Machado. Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Now Manny turns on one and sends it to deep left. And it's gone. into the home bullpen. And now Jake Cronenworth. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. And that is off the wall. And he is in the second with a two-out double. To plate now, Will Myers. This is to left. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Cronenworth isn't stopping. Here he comes to the plate. Safe at the plate. And they lead now by four.
Now that the first baseman, Eric.
So now to the plate, Eric Hosmer. Did well make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Line drive to left. That's in there. Base hit. The throw to the plate. And he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. Austin Adams has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 54.
Into the box now, Tommy Edmond. Low as he's able to lay off the slider. On deck, the powerful right-handed bat of Paul Goldschmidt. And the count will be full. Pulled toward right center field. Back goes Grisham. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Next to stand in is Paul Goldschmidt. He scored after knocking a single in his last at bat. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Swing and a shot toward right center. But this will not get out there deep enough as it's run down by the right fielder in the alley for the second out. So stepping in is Tyler O'Neill. Only four outs remaining for them to try and rally back in this one. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Down the third baseline. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Andrew Miller is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 21.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and digging in is the switch hitting catcher, Victor Caratini. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So one man gone for the Friars in their half of the eighth. And that brings up Trent Grisham. Now the 1-1 pitch. Bases are empty. One man out. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Here now the 2-2. Hit in the air to left field. O'Neill waits on it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Stepping in next, Adam Frazier. He flew out in his last debut. Now the 2-1 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Pierce Johnson will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jake Mariznick will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Nope, that's off the plate.
Waiting on deck, there's Yadi Molina. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And this pitch misses here. It's ball 4. And they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth. Yadi Molina digging in now. For 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. 2 balls and a strike to Molina.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
And another foul ball. Arenado aboard here at first with nobody out. Misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Fouled off. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. This is on the ground over to first. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. He'll hold it second, and there are 2 aboard now.
Now batting the right fielder, Dylan Carlson.
Standing in now, Dylan Carlson.
1-2.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2. Back to the fastball, but it's upstairs. 2 balls and 2 strikes now. 2-2. Popped him up. Caratini waits on it. Looks it into his glove, and there's 1 gone. Mark Melanson takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Sosa, your attention, please.
Edmundo Sosa will be his first assignment here as he'll face it with runners at first and second, and 1 gone. Now the 1-1 pitch. Count is 1-2 now. From the stretch, line to the right side. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And a good throw is going to hold that runner at third. So they're loaded now with only 1 away.
The seventh fielder, Harrison Bader.
At the plate now, Harrison Bader. And he fouls this one off. Hit to first. There's 1. Lars Nootbaar. See what he can do off the bench as he'll bat with runners at the corners and 2 gone here. Now crowd announced at a bit over 23,000 comes to their feet. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Cardinals down to their final strike here. And he lays off the plate and high. 3-2.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
6-3 in the final score today. The Padres sent 5 balls over the wall to come out on top in this one. Ross Detweiler pitches well enough to get the W, so that will wrap things up. Loza, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ballgame for the victorious San Diego Padres. 6 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For St. Louis, 3 runs on 7 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. The winning pitcher is Ross Detweiler. The loss goes to Adam Wainwright. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 10 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.